Hi. 2 days ago, I recorded my second video about how to make baskets hold water. I use the same basket that you're looking at, except that it was outdoors. I since brought it inside, and that was 2 days ago, as I mentioned earlier. And as you can see all the way through the bottom and see that it's still dry. The cardboard liner is still dry. Water does not travel through the plastic bag. In conclusion, I want to say that it is best to use a clear plastic bag because you can see exactly what's at the bottom or what's floating in the water, what etc. There was a piece of dirt in the water and I thought it was below the bag, but it's actually in the water. And I'm trying to fish it, but it's no longer located down there. Fish it out. I got it. There's another little speck that's floating around. So in using a clear bag, you can observe that there is no leak at all. The cardboard doesn't look like any moisture penetrated through because there are no spots. No wet spots, so to speak. And also, you can clearly see when the bag needs to be replaced. So in conclusion, if you are transforming baskets to make them hold water, especially if it's drinking water, use clear plastic bags, whether for drinking or cooking. In that second video, I also mentioned there was another camera, so the footage that you're going to watch is from that other camera. If you watch the first video though, you will learn the mechanical procedure in terms of how to cut the liner or to cut the cardboard liner. It's not too late to mention when you're cutting cardboard or plastic or anything that involves a utility knife, it's always best to direct the cut away from your body. It can start close to your body, but when you extend that hand, make sure it's away from your body. Especially cutting plastic. Cutting plastic is very dangerous with a razor blade or utility knife because the thickness of the plastic changes constantly. So you find yourself in an area that has some resistance, offers some resistance, you add pressure, and next thing you know, the next part of the plastic is very thin and that razor blade goes traveling, and it better not be traveling towards you. It better be traveling away from you. Enjoy the rest of the video. Thank you. Alright, you are looking at a basket that is filled with water. In the other video I explained how I wanted to show people how to store water with a basket inside their homes. And I realized if you cover this basket with another plastic bag, you have a container of water that is fully protected from rain from outside. Therefore, the cardboard will not get wet. Hence, your liner will be fine and will not puncture your inside plastic bag. Since it's windy outside, I also added a rubber band to hold that outside plastic. That's one.
both out. Now, you are looking at the basket filled with water. Going to empty the basket in this other basket. This is a basket as well. It's the plastic basket, made out of soft plastic and doesn't need a liner, but it needs a trash bag to hold water. Should be a slow transfer. I don't want to spill water all over the place. That will turn into ice pretty soon. In bucket. Okay, five buckets this way. Maybe I'll give it another bucket. Alright, the $1,000 shot is to show you that the cardboard is dry inside. And I think I'll make sure the other camera is recording that as well. Hold on. I'm emptying this container. I just dump the water any way I can now. I think I can lift this plastic bag out. Maybe there's a gallon of water left there, but that shouldn't be too heavy. I'll tell you if it's too heavy in a minute. It's not too heavy. And here it comes. No leaks. put it in the bucket. And now we are going to examine what's in there. And as you can see, there's no more left here. Putting it all around.